Hey guys, it's Dessyclef for you. Real quick, let me explain the various functions on the Pixel tw-283 intervalometer and how you can use it for your time lapses and long exposure photography. But before I do, welcome to my channel. If you are new here, I do reviews, upload educational content while entertaining at the same time, anytime. So if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button, smash that bell too, and you wouldn't miss anything I upload, okay? All right.
If you own a camera that has no internal ability to do time lapses, you will need an intervalometer like this Pixel tw-283S2 wireless shutter release that would allow you to do so. The Pixel tw-283 intervalometer comes in this lovely box that includes a receiver that you can mount directly on your camera. It also includes a wireless transmitter, which I'll refer to more often as a remote control in this video. This remote control allows you to control your shutter within 80 meters from your camera in all directions. Another thing included in the box is a shutter connecting cable that connects your camera to the receiver, and this also happens to determine what camera brand you can use the device on. Yes, you heard me right. The Pixel tw-283 is compatible with a lot of camera brands, so if you own more than one camera brand, then you have no problem other than getting the right shutter connecting cable made for the camera model you own. You also find a user manual in the box written in English and in another language, which I suppose is Chinese. The manual is well detailed to help you understand how this device works if you have the time to patiently read through. If you don't have the luxury to do so, relax, this video is meant to help you with that anyway. Something you will need but not find in the box is a battery. Both the receiver and the transmitter needs two AAA batteries each to function, and you need to get that yourself. After rightfully inserting the batteries, you will need to press the power button for 2 seconds on the receiver and the remote control to turn them on. The power button on the remote is also responsible for turning on the LCD backlight on the remote control. The light may not be super bright, but it's very useful when you find yourself doing some night photography in places where there are no lights at all. Remote control. The remote control uses this LED here for indicating its operating status. After pressing the release button, sends a focusing signal to the camera. The camera can be identified to be in a focusing state when the LED on both the remote control and the transmitter are green. When the release button is fully pressed, the green LED changes to red to indicate a signal has been sent to the camera to take a photo. Pressing the directional button to the left or right allows you to move through the various functions this device has to offer. The center button here is the OK button for selecting the option on the display screen for editing or for confirming what you just edited. And below the directional button is the shutter button, rightfully placed in the center. With the power button being on the left, the start and stop button is placed on the right just below the LCD screen. Just as the name states, it helps to start and stop your timer as programmed to control your camera shutter. The shutter functions. The Pixel tw-283 allows you to use your camera shutter in 4 different ways on the remote. The first I'll be looking at is the single shooting function. With this function, upon pressing the shutter button on the remote, a single shutter command is sent to the camera that then takes only one picture, as you would normally do on your camera. The next function I'll be looking at is the continuous shutter function. Here, a shutter command is sent to the camera to take multiple shots when you press down the shutter button on the remote control. I kind of noticed that while the remote is set to continuous shooting, only a single shot is taken when the shutter button is held down. I later discovered this function doesn't seem to work unless the camera is set to continuous shooting drive mode. I don't know if this is happening only on the one I've got or it's the way the device is meant to function. Kindly share your experience with me in the comment section if you are experiencing the same issue on this intervalometer. Bob mode. You will need this mode for doing your long exposure photography. Your camera needs to be set to bob mode to get a desired result. Pressing the shutter button once will open the camera shutter for a long exposure. The remote at this point shows a counting up for you to know how long you have exposed the camera shutter. When you press the shutter again, the counting stops and a photo is taken. When using this function and you don't have your camera set to bulb, what happens is that a photo is taken right before the counting begins, meaning there will be no long exposure and a photo will be taken with the current shutter setting on your camera. Delay shooting. Delay shooting is very useful when you want to take a selfie or time your shutter to take a photo after a given period of time. To change the delay setting here, you need to press the OK button to enter the delay shooting setting. The shooting time value here starts to blink to indicate it's in the edit mode. Pressing the up button would increase the amount of seconds you want the shutter to delay before taking a photo, while the down button decreases the delay time. The left arrow takes you to the number of shots setting. Here, you have to set the intervalometer to take between 1 and 59 photos. When you are done with the editing, press the center button to save your new setting. A full press of the shutter button will start the delay sequence by sending the shooting information to the receiver as the remote displays the delay countdown, after which the receiver would output one shooting signal every 1 second until the number of shots indicated in the delay shooting sequence is taken. Timer schedule shooting functions. Delay. Delay here is where you set the amount of time you want the camera to wait before the photo shooting sequence begins. This can be set to 0 seconds for immediate start or a maximum time of 99 hours. The amount of time indicated here for delay would only apply once and not repeat itself. I would explain better later with an example. Long. Long here is where you set the exposure time and it only works in bulb mode, meaning the camera has to be set to bulb. If your camera is not set to bulb mode, it's just going to take the exposure using the shutter speed as set in your camera. Here in long, the camera will take the dialed amount of time to expose before a shot is taken. Interval. Interval is the wait time in between peaks. The wait time in between your long exposures. It is the time a transmitter waits after a shot to trigger another long sequence. N1. N1 is the shooting times. That is the number of pictures you want the camera to take in a long interval cycle. Let me explain better. When I dial 2 here, I'm telling the transmitter to take a picture using the long setting, then exercise a wait period using the amount of time dialed as interval, then take another picture using the long setting again. So, a total number of 2 pictures will be taken in this cycle. If I dial 4 in N1, then 4 pictures will be taken in this N cycle. N1 set to 3 means the shutter exposes, takes the pics, waits the interval period, exposes again, takes another pics, waits the interval period again, exposes and takes the third pics. So it takes 3 pictures in total. Repeat. Let me come back to this after explaining the next function. N2. N2 is where you indicate the number of times you want N1, which is the shooting time, and the interval cycle to repeat itself. N2 ranges from 1 to 99, or infinity, which is when the transmitter will keep sending the repeat signal until the battery dies down or you turn it off. Now, let me return to repeat, which I jumped earlier. Repeat is not what the name sounds like. I don't know why they named it repeat. They could have named it something else other than repeat. Repeat is where you indicate the amount of time you want the transmitter to wait in between N2 cycles. That is, if in my N2, I indicated that N1 cycle should be repeated 3 times, as I explained earlier. When the first N1 cycle is completed, the transmitter waits the amount of time I indicated in repeat before it starts another N1 cycle. If I'm to make a formula of all I just said, it will be something like this. N1 equals your long plus your interval. N2 equals your long plus your interval multiplied by your N1 cycle plus repeat. Thank you for watching. I really appreciate your time spent watching this video. Don't forget to drop a like if you found it helpful and subscribe if you haven't done that already. Dessyclef signing out. Peace.